replaced him, okay?
My phone died, so I had to switch phones.
What's the longest when I'm going back? All right, for our next section, we're working our way diagonal back, okay? Which means we are angling our cone away from the face. Diagonal forward be toward the face, if that makes sense, okay? So our next section, we're going to take a 1A subsection. No, I'm sorry. We're going to take a 1A subsection back towards the face, diagonal back. We're going to leave that, we're going to call that negative space, okay? This is what actually ensures that you're creating dimension. You're going to take another 1A subsection. And that section, you're going to leave that, and we're not going to do any highlighting to that area. Take a 1/8 of an inch subsection. That's, we're gonna leave that one. That is gonna be our negative space. This is how we're gonna create the dimension. Okay. Now we're gonna take another 1/8 subsection. And we're now going to do what's called a slice. We'll take a 1/8 inch subsection. So that 1/8 inch subsection that you just took, all of this hair is gonna go in the fold. Okay? That's the slice. That's the difference between a slice and a weave. Make sense? Open foil packet in just a second so that you're able to see the amount of saturation of product that I have in this foil, okay? See how I'm laying my brush flat to work toward the scalp? And that is so that I can have control and so that I don't have a huge line of demarcation. But so it is, because horizontal lines create hard lines. Okay. This is how much lighter is on my foil. And it's saturated evenly and properly, so the foil, if you can see, I'm not holding it, it's holding itself. Okay? Now, for this, go ahead.
So you said this part right here, but you said don't touch right here, right?
Hold on real quick.
This part right here.
So you took a 1/8 subsection. This is 1/8. Yeah. All right, this is called negative space, so we're going to leave this alone, okay? We're going to do nothing to this. This, 1H subsection, all of it is going into the format. That's called a slice, okay? Now for the purpose of this exercise, I'm gonna do a trifold for this one. My comb to secure to the diameter of my slice or weave. Okay? Over-direct it. Over-direct the hair. So over-direct the hair back this way. Hold it. No, you hold it. Over-direct it. And hold it like that. Just hold it down. There you go. Get your brush. No, won't get any more than that. A lot. Get a lot. A lot more than that. There we go. Now smooth on the side. Smooth on the side. Both sides. Both sides smooth. Smooth. Just go back and forth. Go back and forth. Just like that. Now, press hard. Press real hard. Real, nope, nope, nope. Mid shaft right here. Yep. But I think it's all the back, so that's gonna hit you. Go ahead. Press hard. Press real hard. Got it? You have to press a little bit harder because it's gonna slip. So you gotta press really hard. Let me show you. When you press down at the mid-shaft, you gotta press like this, hard. That way you can walk away your forearm. Okay? Then, once you've evenly saturated the lighter down the shaft, then you take your hands and you just fold them up into the section. Okay? You can't be afraid of it. This isn't color. Okay, this is lighter. So if you want, because it has to not only penetrate to the top, it has to penetrate to the bottom. Okay? And then you want a flat side, so like a pancake, right? And just smooth. So yes. And in essence, when you're going in the downward section, it's actually pulling the hair down into the bowl even more. Okay? And you want to pull the pancake. Do a trifold. But remember what I said, this right here. So now, if there was a mistake, I couldn't fix it because your security is on the inside instead of the outside. Does that make sense? Does that make sense? But that's okay. We'll get it.
I'm gonna have to do some.
All right. Now, so we've done a natural weave, we've done a slice. For our next section, we're gonna leave out another negative space. And then we're going to do a texture weave, okay?
Oh, the battery is low.
So we're going to have to switch to there. Okay? Okay. All right, so for our next section, we're going to take another 1/8 inch subsection. This is going to be our negative space. I'm going to leave this out, okay? Now, at this point, because that I'm moving towards the other side of the recession, I'm going to diagonal back off this section here, and I'm going to secure it away, because I'll come back to that. Subsection. Now I'm going to do a texture view. Now, all that simply means is my ribbons go from being 8 to 10 small to 6 to 8, depending on your section. Now, in order to accomplish that, I'm going to move away from the scalp now because I want to be able to see how big my sections are. So now I'm going to be falling from the mid shaft, okay? As you can see, these weeds are a little bit bigger, okay? That's a textured weed. then another 1/8 inch, and we're gonna do a textured weave. 6 to 8 ribbons. Instead of starting at the scalp with your ribbons, you're gonna actually do it from the midshaft. Okay, you're gonna start weaving from your midshaft.
Charger last night, and so I usually do at night, but I have this extra mask. Sorry, guys, didn't mean to disturb you. You have to transition myself because I think the plug is going to be.
Yeah, when there's one right here.
Okay, that's fine. Or, yeah. This one over here is probably the better for this. Yeah.
So you said I split it up already.
Okay, hold on here. Let me close this one up and adjust them.
Here I come. The same thing.
Okay. Yeah.
So
this is your bottom one, this is your top one.
Yes. No, I'm not this one.
Yes, this one.
Yep.
How it's supposed to be. All right,
so I'm gonna move closer. There we go.
Okay, I did a trifold plastic fold on this one.
Just from the mid shaft.
How are you doing, team? Okay. Let me secure with my negative space and I'm trying. Okay. Just like that, yeah. The flat brush. You're still doing a pencil. Flat. There we go. Very good. See how you can distribute more instead of trying to write, instead of trying to write it.
The shampoo makes it really slippery. That might be the
same thing with balayage. Balayage is about 3 hand painting, so it's all about the smoothness. Okay.
So from the mid shaft, and then
black hole.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm going to do the tri-fold, but I'm going to fold it again.
Okay.
This side, and on the other side. Okay, and that's the one from the mid shaft.
Push it up, yep, just push it up. There you go. And then, hold it down and then pull pressure. There you go. Now come down just a little bit. There you go. So I want you to put your lighter really hard right there. Press real hard. Now move your hand. All right, we're doing good here on campus. Now, for our final weaving, okay? Our next one is gonna be the placement, so I already have my negative space secured, okay? I'm gonna take another 1/8 inch subsection. Now I'm gonna do a placement weave, which is gonna give me 2 to 3, 3 to 4, they're large, okay? And this is so you can create some boldness in there, okay? So you're going to do really big weaves depending on how much I can give you, okay? So you see these sections compared to, I don't know if you can see these. Can you see these ribbons compared to the other ribbons? They're really large, okay? I was only able to ribbon out two. Those are more of a texture. I would much rather you have 2 strands of hair in your hair instead of 3. These are for bold pieces. to me.
Very bold.
I'm gonna pull down. I'm gonna hold there. Yeah, that's good. Yep. Starting at the mid shaft, applying pressure, removing my hand, using my hand as a base, smoothing the lightener down. Continuing to smooth. Now my next section, I'm gonna show you a little trick, but this is not for your state board, okay? This is not what you're gonna do at state board. I mean, could you probably do it at state board, but I would suggest not. This is more for when you are getting out in the field and you really are
very
in a hurry.
Sections. Like a bold highlight. One, two, three ribbons.
All right, let me just refresh while they're walking through. So we're in the highlighting 101, we went over types of folds. There's a classic fold where you're just moving the fold up once and securing the two ends. The trifold where you're folding up twice and securing the ends. And the double secure where you are doing a classic fold, but you're building it at the end just in case you have any slippage or things like that, you can actually secure the hair so it actually traps the heat. Went over types of weaves. A natural weave is going to give you 8 to 10 ribbons where you're weaving closer to the scalp, in and out. Textured weave where you're weaving at the mid shaft and it's probably going to give you 6 to 8 ribbons. And your placement weave, which is for most bold placements, I always call them money pieces. You can do money pieces anywhere. You can do them all over the head. You can do them around the face to frame the face more. Do it to give boldness and a little bit more lightness and coverage at the crown area. You can put a money piece anywhere. But those are going to be 2 to 3, beautiful 4 to 6, depending on how long the hair is or how wide the head is. But mostly 2 to 3, 3 to 4, okay? Slicing is done either diagonal back, which is away from the face, or diagonal forward, which is toward the face. Horizontal is going to create hard lines. Not saying that it's wrong. Horizontal placement is just fine. If you're working on, I would say horizontal placement would be good if you're just trying to put like peekaboos in the hair. Meaning very solid, very concentrated like pieces that you want to make sure that people see. That is
why
with the way horizontal on a subsection. But for most subsections, when you're doing the highlighting, they should be either vertical, diagonal back, or diagonal forward. Okay. Now, let me check this for you. So I just want you to make sure that when you're securing it's a little cleaner, okay? So just take your combs in here, like this. Instead of squishing them, okay?
And just take your comb on this one as well.
Stick it to the diameter of your thing. Okay? Now, I'm gonna give you a little extra trick. So, when you do a lot of highlighting, okay? As a colorist myself, right? I do sometimes prep foils so that I can get through the process, especially if I know they have a lot of hair. And if I know that maybe I worked with this client and I've had problems with slippage, I'll take my foil and I'll take a little bit of lighter and I'll slide it down the foil just like this, okay? And especially for darker hair, I'll do this as well, because what it will allow me to do is when I lay the hair into this lighter, it will actually lighten the back and the top. But I'm gonna do the top, and this lighter works on the back. And I normally do this with levels 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'll always try to prep my foils if I know their hair is really dark and I'm gonna have to work the lighter, so that I can make sure that it penetrates top and bottom, okay? Without any lines of demarcation. All right. So, what I want you to continue to do is to work diagonal back, alternating types of weaves and slices, and then I want you to work diagonal back in that small subsection that we created so that you can have a nice boldness in it right in the hairline. So work this way diagonal back, work diagonal back left and diagonal back right, so it's almost going to lay on top of each other like a fan, okay? And that will be our mini partial. And once we finish that, we'll take a look at your placement. Alexa? Don't forget, after you finish your application, when you're working from home, make sure you film it. I'm sorry, make sure you, if you haven't filmed it, you need to film yourself doing it. You need to, and the ones that are on campus, take a picture and upload for your grades, okay? T, can you turn yourself this way? Like turn, like flip your body. So you back it into the camera. Yes, work this way. And turn her around. Yeah, like that. Like that. Okay, you're right. Like this. And I'm gonna go slow right there. Okay.
Leave my recording and just keep working on it. The gel that actually sticks. jowl. Okay, so here's my first set of foiling practice. So obviously once I switched to gel, it was a lot easier. But this is kind of what it looks like.